Hello everyone, this is Shapnam here. Welcome back to my channel, The Counseling Corner. Have you ever felt that the initial spark in your relationship has disappeared? Or are you worried that there is no more love, passion, and romance in your relationship? It is quite common for people who are in long-term relationship to feel this way. But have you ever realized why this happened? There are two main reasons for this. One is that initially when you started the relationship, you would have been ever ready to do anything to keep your partner happy and spend as much as time with your partner. But as the relationships become older, the partners start taking each other for granted and stop doing those small things which they used to do initially. The second reason is that their priorities change. They become so busy focusing on other priorities like taking care of the children or focusing on their career or their work, and they start neglecting the partner. Remember one thing: if the physical and emotional needs of the partner is not fulfilled, then they start looking for it elsewhere. This is the reason why you would hear that many relationships are breaking, or people feel stuck in an unhappy relationship, or people know they cheat each other by getting into illegal relationships. If you had treated your partner the same way as you have treated in the initial days, then this would not happen and your relationship would have been evergreen. Do you wish to bring back that love and passion back into your relationship? It's never too late. So please do view this video till the end and try incorporating these practical tips into your life so that you can bring back the romance and passion back into your relationship and lead a fulfilling life. But before I could start with the tips, a gentle reminder. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe as well as hit the bell icon so that you get timely notifications whenever I post my new video. So the first tip is that you need to take care of your physical and emotional health. Only if you're physically and emotionally fit and you feel good about yourself and you love yourself, you would be able to give love to your partner. But if you're unwell and then don't feel good about yourself, you will always be in an irritated mood, and that will have a negative impact on your relationship. You need to take care of hygiene. You need to take care of how you look, how you dress, as you used to do in the initial days to impress your partner. So you do exercise regularly, keep yourself fit so that you are attractive to your partner. The second thing is that you need to make your partner your priority. No matter how busy you are, how many priorities you have, you need to set aside some time every day to spend quality time with your partner. You can go for a walk together, and you should always be present when your partner is in need of you. For example, if your partner is unwell, you can just take a day off and spend some time with your partner and give personal care. You can take your partner to the doctor and express your love to your partner. The third point is that go on a date night at least once in a week and spend quality, intimate time together. You can just watch a movie holding hands, or go for a candlelight dinner, or go for a long drive and discuss many things. The fourth point is that you have to recall your past memories. This you can do by looking at your old photographs and discussing about your past experiences, maybe your first date or your honeymoon or the time you had the first kid, and recall these happy memories. As well as you need to recall those tough times in your life when you were supportive to each other, stood by each other, and how successfully you overcame those challenges in your life. So when you start recalling your past happy moments, then you will start having an urge to re-experience that happiness, and both of you will try doing something to work towards it. The fifth point, make your partner feel loved and special. Remember, physical touch is very, very important, not only to keep the spark alive, but also to relieve the stress and anxiety. So give them a lot of hug and kisses. And when they are communicating to you, look into their eyes, right? And pay full attention to what they are communicating so that they will feel that their views and feelings are being appreciated. As well as once in a way, you can leave some text messages, and from office, you can just call them and tell them how much you miss them. And in the evening when you're getting back, you can get some chocolates or flowers and give them a surprise. Very often you have to keep communicating to them how much you love them, what they mean to you, and how blessed you feel to have them in your life. So by doing these small things, these small things will go a long way in bringing back the passion and romance back into your life. The sixth point is that try out something new which you together, which you have never done earlier. For example, you can go for a trekking together, or you can start exercise together. No, you can try out a new dish together in the kitchen, or you can also go on an adventurous trip, or even try start a new project together, so that you can spend quality time and as much as time together. Seventh point is that you need to love your partner using their love language. See, for each one, the way they express or they receive and give love is different. So you need to understand what is their love language. Some might feel loved when they are appreciated, some when we spend quality time with them, some when we help them in the task, and few others when they get sudden surprise gifts. So first understand that. For example, if your partner feels loved when you spend quality time with your partner, then you need to ensure you take out some time every day and spend time with them. And if you feel that they get, feel loved, if you give them surprise gifts, then you can start giving them surprise gifts. Eighth point is giving surprise gifts. Giving surprise gifts can go a long way in bringing back romance into your relationship. So you can just take them for a movie, or just take them for dinner out, or give them some surprise gifts, as well as plan a trip for them. The ninth point, never make the mistake of forgetting the important dates in your life, like your wedding anniversary, or your first date, or your birthday. Ensure that you remember these dates and give them some surprise. The last and the most important point is that get intimate. This is very, very essential, and it's very important to reconnect with your partner. So you need to ensure that at least you spare once in a week for your physical affection. But unfortunately, there are many couples who have gone years and months together without physical affection. So you see, if you are physically intimate, it not only helps you to relieve your stress and anxiety, but it will increase your trust in each other and will make you feel secure in the relationship, as well as it will make both the partners feel young and energetic. So this is the best way to bring back romance and passion back into your relationship. But in case you find that the physical intimacy is lacking in your relationship, then you have to immediately speak to your partner, discuss openly, and take some action and work towards it. You can also take the help of the counselor if required. So these are few practical tips which you have to incorporate into your lives and follow it consistently if you want to bring back that spark, romance, and passion into your relationship. But remember, both the partners should be ready and willing to work towards it. Hope this information was useful to you, and in case it was useful to you, please do give me a thumbs up. Do subscribe to my channel, The Counseling Corner. Share my video with your friends, and most important is hit the bell icon so that you get timely notifications whenever I post my new video. See you next time.